Hi guys, Namaskar and Swagat hai aap sabka on your favorite show. This is India's leading reality show, of course the biggest search for the next top model. And you guessed it right, this is the Honda Gladride's Mega Model and Manhunt 2016. This is a TV reality show in association with Panasonic Beauty and Himalayan Face Wash. Now, as you have seen, देश भर में हुए थे इतने सारे ऑडिशंस जहां आए थे लाखों लोग आजमाने अपनी किस्मत. वेल, आफ्टर दोज नॉट सो इजी एंड वेरी डिफिकल्ट ऑडिशंस, हम पहुंच गए हैं फाइनली मुंबई लेके दोज लकी फ्यू फाइनलिस्ट. अब दे आर ऑल सेट टू कम्पीट टू बी दैट नेक्स्ट बिग फेस इन द वर्ल्ड ऑफ मॉडलिंग. Guys, अब Gladride टॉप मॉडल बनना चाहे कितना भी आसान या डिफिकल्ट हो, बट वन थिंग इज फॉर श्योर दैट व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट Gladride, वी डेफिनेटली टॉक अबाउट लग्जरी एंड स्टाइल, एंड दैट्स एग्जैक्टली व्हाट यू गोना सी नेक्स्ट. तो चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं और देखते हैं हमारे Gladride के मॉडल रह कहाँ रहे हैं. कम लेट्स टेक अ लुक.
What a beautiful house, man.
See you guys, you know we're going to get etiquette classes from Mrs. Vardia.
I know what that.
This place is like heaven.
I know, this is amazing. It's super comfortable, yeah.
This is awesome place, bro. I think you're gonna party, huh?
Got it.
So natural, it's beautified.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Maureen Wadia, and it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to this occasion. Today, the class of 2016 of India's most glamorous guys and girls are here. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's another batch, and it's the Honda Gladride's Mega Model Manhunt TV reality series in association with Panasonic Beauty and Himalaya Face Wash. Well, each and every one of these girls and guys has earned a position here. And today, I am welcoming them for the first time to my Gladride's Career Academy, Mumbai, where stars are born and model legends are made. Now, the training begins.
Shine so bright like the stars in the sky.
Welcome to an etiquette class at the Glad Rags Career Academy. This is called Table Etiquette. You face this every day, whether you go out with your parents, whether you go out with your girlfriend, or whether you're invited to a party, or when you get older and you have a big party in your own home, this would be called a formal sit-down dinner. The first rule about a dinner is that you always place people in a way that they can talk to each other. If she is the biggest bore in the world, I, as a hostess, would place her next to two people who I know can make her talk. The other thing about table etiquette is you never put two guys together or two girls together. The first thing that happens when you look at this table, you are puzzled. Where to begin? So the first thing you do is pick up the napkin. Pick up the napkin very slowly from here. There's a napkin ring. Put the ring slowly back here. Take your napkin and put it under the table on your lap. So there are two plates, so that means that this is a two-course meal. That means you're going to have a starter, you're going to have a main course, and at the end of it, if you have a dessert or a pudding, then all of these plates will go and you'll get a fresh plate for your dessert. You've got to remember, all liquor is served from the right side and all food is served from the left side. There's a barrage of glasses here. Now, common sense would tell us that the largest glass would be for
water.
Right. So this, can you lift it? The largest glass is for water. Okay. Now you put it down. The main thing about formal dining is what you pick up from wherever, you return it to that formation. It's like being in the army. The smaller glass that is for white wine, the larger glass that is for red wine. First and foremost, you never pour wine higher than this. But if you're serving red wine, the normal practice is to open the bottle of red wine long before you start serving food. You put it in a decanter or you leave it in the bottle, but you leave it for 2 hours before at room temperature to breathe. If this were my dinner and I was serving, I would have white wine to start with, if that's strictly formal. White wine would go with the starter. Starter would be anything. It could be soup, or it could be a small salad with a little bit of chicken in it or something, like a chicken salad. White wine always goes best with white meat. Remember, red, fruity colors, more associated with fruit, dessert, things like that. If you're going to start eating, you're going to wonder, how do I start? You need to start from the outside and work yourself inside. This is what? This is a fish knife and a fish fork. Totally different from a normal knife and fork. If you can see, they're totally different. You had a question?
What do I do if the girl I'm with, I'm out dining, and if she wants to go to the washroom?
Yes.
So should I escort her to the washroom or should I be sitting at the table?
No, it's a good question. Then push your chair back, put your napkin back on the table. You would have to put your napkin back on the table. Yes. And if she's getting up, you would just pull the chair so that she could go out. Right? Now let's pretend she's gone out, and when she comes back again, you have to stand up again. So go for it, stand up. See, this is what you call table etiquette, because it's always ladies. You have to pull the chair or push it forward or push it back. It's ladies first. When you go out on a date or something, always show moderation. Don't get yourself totally drunk. Most women get very nervous when faced with alcohol, because a lot of girls
really don't drink, but they want to show off that, you know, I'm really angry. And one sip can lead to another sip. So, you know, if you think that getting a girl drunk is a route to success, it's an absolute road to disaster. Now, let's begin, get back to our meal. So when you're eating, keep knife and fork parallel to the table, like this, like oars in a boat. And when you're eating, there's going to be no noise, no cut, 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 okay? So you cut it, you use the fork for putting the food in your mouth. You can put it this way or you could use it this way, but the correct way is this way. Now when you finish with this, you put your knife and fork together, slightly to the side. If you leave it like this, that's American style and it's really bad manners. Eating with from here, also not a good idea, okay? It's a handle. Stick to the handles, okay? The chrome part, the silver part is strictly meant to cut, help you, whatever. So always, the higher you use it, the better. Don't go like that because that is crazy, okay? So you go down here. Now, for example, if you are served curry and rice, this, yes, yes.
But what if you eat with your left hand? Are you still supposed to hold the fork and the knife in the same hand?
That is a good question. But I think what you need to do is quietly reverse the cutlery while no one's looking without making too much of a noise so you can engage somebody in conversation and do the transfer. So now we finish and this goes. So this plate goes, right? When this plate goes, we come to the main course, okay? So we're going to put these plates back for a minute. So right now, I'm being served. I'm not going to serve everybody, not because I don't want you to eat, but only because it makes it quicker. So what you do is when this comes to you to serve yourself, don't go around digging around for what you can find if this is a biryani or a pulao, okay? Try, if you are digging for whatever, make it subtle. But basically start from this side and this is to hold it together. So if you start, say, with this much rice, and when you finish, you return this back to its original position, okay? You've got to be very careful. You don't leave this there or anywhere because it's got to go to the next person. And the service would go around this way, okay? So it always will go this clockwise. Sorry, anti-clockwise. If you want to put your curry on top here or you want to put your curry down there, it's entirely up to you. If you want to take some gravy or whatever, that's up to you, okay? The whole intention is not to make a mess. Now, if you drop one of the forks or the spoons in this, leave it alone. Don't start fishing around. The server will take it away and fix it. So we start with this, right? So this is how you start. Now, you can't make a racket, no making a noise. You've got to remember that you've got to use this finger to support or propel or push your knife. You're basically working on your thumb and this finger, okay? So the rest of the spoon is going into your hand, okay? So then you're in control. Show me. Okay, you're in control. In control, in control. You're out of control. You're almost up here. Go down. Yes. Stick to the handle area, okay? Right. And don't try and act too fancy by going like that because that is off the charts, okay? When you are eating like this, remember paddles, oars of a boat. Keep it parallel to your, yes, and put it together, okay? So when I stop, say if we're eating and I stop to talk to one of you, I would leave it like this and continue my conversation, okay? But I wouldn't make that much noise. When you finish, you always put the two together, which is an indication that it's over, okay? Now, after this is finished, these plates will be taken away.
Guys don't get this because they say, you know, why should we have this girly way of holding this glass?
Haath rakh do. To kya ye sahi hoga?
I am blocking these people. Wine glasses have changed a lot. They have now become what is called goblets. Now, when you drink white wine, you should never put your hand around it. White wine is served chilled. And when it's absolutely chilled, guys don't get this because they say, you know, why should we have this girly way of holding this glass? But this is a stem. Hold the glass by the stem, because if you hold it from here, you're going to heat up the glass with your body temperature. Red wine, on the other hand, you can put your hands around it if you want to.
मेरा एक सवाल होगा मैम।
जी।
अगर मैं नहीं पी रहा हूँ वाइन और ये जो ग्लास है अगर मैं इसके ऊपर ऐसे से हाथ रख दूँ तो क्या ये सही होगा?
नहीं, ये बिल्कुल गलत है। क्यों? आपको इशारा से बोल देना चाहिए नो थैंक यू। ओके? But you can't put your hand on top of the glass. This has now come as your dessert. And whatever you're left with on the table is your dessert. Somebody's come, taken an order, or if you're at somebody's house, this is pre-served. When you talk to somebody at the table, don't block a person. See, if you sit at a table with both your hands like this, your body language is showing that you actually don't want to talk to anybody. When people fly, you get a small tray with your food and you have to eat in a small area. Try and eat neatly, and when you finish, put your knife and your fork on a side, or if you have place on the plate, eat it there. That's the end of a lesson on etiquette. It's not just how you dress, it's how you talk, it's how you hold yourself. It's how you project yourself. That is the model of yourself. Today you want to be models, but tomorrow the models will go further than today. My aim is to give you a full image change. So from now onwards, when somebody looks at you, they will say, that's a mega model. So welcome to the Glad Rags Mega Model and Manhunt, and may all of you become model legends, and may all of you become stars. Cheers.
Cheers, ma'am.
You write your own destiny, you write your own fate. Dino Moria was the first one who put six packs on the map. Hi there, girls and boys. I am delighted to have each and every one of you. And I know it's been a tough journey. It's been a dream. For some of you, this has been something that you've grown up watching. The hunt where bodies were discovered. Dino Moria was the first one who put six packs on the map. This is no paradise. This is the Maureen Wadia Boot Camp. I was not an army kid. I'm not a general, but I think I am a general among the models. One thing you will learn from me, and this is something that I gift each and every one of you, and hope that that is what you will carry with you forever. You write your own destiny. You write your own fate. So guys and girls, you want to be a model, you want to dream, dream. But dreaming has an expiry date. Now, during the course of the next 10 days, you will really know what modeling is all about. And at this stage, all I have to do is say, I wish you loads of luck, and may your lives be exactly what you want them to be. Big hand of applause to all of you, and welcome. Okay. The girls and boys from all over India are here for the Honda Glad Rags Mega Model Manhunt pageant in association with Panasonic Grooming and Himalaya Herbal Face Wash. So, this is their certificate to say that they have been in the Glad Rags Mega Model Manhunt 2016. It's almost like graduation day. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Congratulations, so much. And that's for you. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Maureen Wadia signing off. Thank you for being with us. And if you want to see glamour in the making, you're in the right place.